So today we are going to solve question number 11. Seema Limited offered for subscription 10,000 shares of rupees 25, each payable 5 rupees per share on application, rupees 10 per share on allotment, including rupees 5 per share as premium, rupees 5 per share as first call on the shares, and the balance in two equal amount at intervals of 3 months. All the shares were applied for and allotted. All the money was received except the second call and final call on 200 and 400 shares respectively. Pass the entries in the company's journal, cash book and ledger. Also shows company's balance sheet on the completion of the above transactions. Okay, dear children, so let's start. So company has issued 10,000 shares of rupees 25 at rupees 5 premium, 5 rupees on application, 5 rupees on allotment plus 5 premium, 5 on first call, 5 on second, 5 on third and final call. There are two adjustments. 200 shareholders not paid second call money and third call money, final call money, and 200 shareholder not paid final call money, means total 400 shares not paid final call money. 400 shareholders not paid final call money. First, we are going to prepare cash book. 2. Share application. How much money is received? 5 rupees at the time of application. 10,000 into 5, 50,000. Then we receive at the time of allotment, 2 share allotment. How much? 10 rupees. So 10 into 10,000, rupees 1 lakh. And then we are going to receive at the time of first call. So 2 share first call. 2 share first call. How much we are going to receive? 10,000 shares multiplied by 5. So 50,000. There is no adjustment at the time of first call. Now at the time of second call, 2 share second call. How much we are going to receive? Children, 10,000 shares into 5, 50,000. I am writing in inner column because there is one adjustment. There is one shareholder who has not paid second call money, 200 shareholders. So 200 into 5 means 1,000 rupees is not paid calls in arrears. So 49,000 is received at the time of share second call. And in the same manner, 2 share third and final call. 2 share third and final call. How much we are going to receive? 10,000 multiplied by 5. Again, I am writing in inner column, 50,000 I am going to receive. But one shareholder, 2 shareholder, 200 and 200 means 400 shareholders not paid third and final call money. So 400 into 5 means 2,000 rupees is calls in arrears not received. 50 minus 2, 48,000 is received. So when we do the total, it becomes 2,97,000 by balance carried down 2,97,000. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now let's prepare journal entries for the transactions. Journal entries. Okay, so children, when we prepare cash book now, so at the time of journal we will pass entries other than cash transactions, like first entries bank account debit to share application will not be recorded. Okay, so here we start share application account debit. Share application account debit to share capital. How many shares are issued? 10,000 shares are issued and 5 rupees is application money. 10,000 into 5, 50,000 we are going to receive. Being application money received. Being application money received. okay. Then second, case for allotment. So share allotment account debit to share capital. To share capital and to security premium reserve. Security premium reserve. So share capital 5 rupees, SPR is 5 rupees at the time of allotment, total is 10. And how many shares are issued? 10,000 shares are issued. It means 1 lakh rupees, 50,000 and 50,000 being share allotment money due. Being share allotment money due. Okay. Then third entry is for first call. Share first call account debit to share capital. What is the price? Face value is 5 rupees. How many shares? 10,000 shares. 10,000 into 5. 50,000. Money due at the time of first call. Being first call money due. Being first call money due. Okay. In the same manner, we will pass entry for second call. Share second call account debit to share capital. To share capital. How much? Again, the face value is 5 rupees. And how many shares? 10,000 shares issued. 10,000 into 5. 50,000. Being share second call money due. And in this question, there is one adjustment of calls in arrears. Money is not received at the time of second call. So calls in arrears account debit. Calls in arrears account debit to share second call. Okay, how much? How many shares? So 200 shareholders didn't pay 5 rupees. So 200 into 5, 1000 rupees is calls in arrears at the time of second call. Money not received on share second call. Then we will pass entry for third and final call. Share third and final call account debit to share capital. To share capital. 10,000 shares are issued. And 5 rupees is face value. 10 into 5, 50,000 rupees is due. Being third and final call money due. Being third and final call money due. Then what happened? Again, there is one adjustment, calls in arrears. Money not received, calls in arrears account debit to share third and final call. So 400 shareholders didn't pay third call money 5 rupees, 4 5 ja, 2000 rupees is not received. Being 400 shareholders not paid third and final call money. Okay, so all the journal entries are over. Now let me prepare ledgers. Okay, so first I prepare share application account. Share application account. So how it is prepared? Pay attention. To share capital 50,000, because 5 rupees was applicable and 10,000 share was there, and money is received by cash account. 50,000 rupees is received. 50,000 and 50,000 in this manner share application account is prepared. Now let us prepare share allotment account. Share allotment account. See how to prepare share allotment account. It is also very easy. 10,000 shares are issued and 5 rupees was applicable. So to share capital 50,000, but security premium reserve is also applicable. So to security premium reserve will also come here. 50,000 and whole money is received. 1 lakh is received. So we write by cash account 1 lakh rupees. In the same manner, we will prepare share first call account. Okay. Share first call account. Okay. How many shares are issued? 10,000 shares are issued. So to share capital 10,000 share and 5 rupees was applicable. 50,000. There is no adjustment. Whole money is received of first call. So by cash account 50,000 rupees is received. Now the same entries and same posting we will do for share second call. Share second call account. Let us prepare. It is very easy. It is very simple, dear children. There is no difficulty. Okay, how many shares are issued? You can see, dear children. How many shares are issued? 10,000 shares are issued. So to share capital 5 rupees was payable. So 10,000 into 5, 50,000 rupees. But 1,000 rupees is not received at the time of second call. So we will transfer in by calls in arrears account. 1,000 rupees was calls in arrears, remember, and rest of the money is received by cash account. 49,000 rupees is received at the time of second call. 50,000. And there is one more account, share third and final call account. Share third and final call account. Okay, it is very simple account, it is not very difficult. Simply just once you understand the concept, now it is very simple to prepare. Okay, how many shares are issued? Again, you remember, 10,000 shares are issued, and at the time of third call, final call, 5 rupees was payable. So 10,000 into 5, 50,000 rupees is payable. The amount which is not received is calls in arrears at the time of third call. Calls in arrears, and 2,000 rupees was calls in arrear at the time of third call. By rest of the money is received. So by cash account 48,000 rupees money is received. So 50,000 rupees. Okay, and the last part which is left, and that is balance sheet. We need to prepare balance sheet. So I will prepare balance sheet for all of you. Balance sheet. This balance sheet part is also very simple. We start with equity and liabilities. Under equity and liabilities, the first head which comes, that is shareholder fund. Under shareholders fund, the first subhead which comes, that is share capital. And we put one note number, okay, and then we write amount. So how much, what is the total of cash account? That is 2,97,000. So that will come here in front of share capital. There is no other item, so 2,97,000 will come here. And then second, in asset side, non-current assets are not given, so the main head will be current assets. And under current assets, dear children, there is only one item which can come, that is cash and cash equivalent. We put note number 2 and we will show 2,97,000 in cash and cash equivalent. 2,97,000. Okay, dear children, I hope the question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children.